The Philippine government set to build field hospitals to accommodate the surge in COVID-19 patient admissions. Treatment Chief Leopoldo Vega says these field or modular hospitals can be built in 45 days with the help of the Public Works Department. Vega says they are also working to expand the capacity of the One Hospital Command Center, which monitors hospital occupancy and facilitates the referral of coronavirus patients.
Now we are receiving almost 400 calls per day. And it's kind of overwhelms also the number of agents that are going to refer patients to the different hospitals. So this is one of the weaknesses that we have, and we are seeking the understanding and the patience of the public, because we're trying to improve our command center so we can best respond and serve the public better.
The U.S. and over a dozen other countries slammed the World Health Organization's newly released report on the origins of the novel coronavirus, citing a lack of full access to data. As this report tells us, the WHO is blaming China for that.
World Health Organization investigators spent 4 weeks earlier this year in and around Wuhan, China, to research the origins of the COVID-19 pandemic. But in remarks about the final reports, the WHO's director general said China withheld data from investigators. The United States and 13 other countries on Tuesday promptly expressed concerns that the report was delayed and lacked access to complete data.
The report lacks crucial data, information.
White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki on Tuesday faulted China for not offering independent experts unfettered access.
Well, they have not been transparent. They have not provided underlying data. That certainly doesn't qualify as cooperation. The analysis performed to date from our experts, their concern is that there isn't additional support for one hypothesis. It doesn't lead us to any closer of an understanding or greater knowledge than we had 6 to 9 months ago about the origin. It also doesn't provide us guidelines or recommended steps on how we should prevent this from happening in the future. And those are imperative.
The WHO report said the virus had probably been transmitted from bats to humans through another animal, and that a lab leak was extremely unlikely as a cause.
There are areas where we had difficulties getting down to the raw data.
WHO's mission leader, Peter Ben-Emberick, told reporters that second-phase studies were needed. He said the team felt political pressure, including from outside China, but that he was never pressed to remove anything from its final reports.
In China, like in many other countries, there are restrictions on privacy laws that forbid the sharing of data, including private details to outsiders, in particular if the data are moving out of the country.
And Barrick also told reporters it was perfectly possible the virus had been circulating in November or October of 2019 around Wuhan, potentially spreading to other countries earlier than what has been documented so far.
The Philippine Interior and Local Government Department admits there is a possibility pandemic financial aid could end up being used in next year's national elections. That's why the DILG is setting up a hotline where people can report local officials who fail to distribute the right amount of aid. Earlier this week, President Duterte approved the release of 23 billion pesos as emergency subsidy to Filipinos in areas placed under enhanced community quarantine.
Hindi natin maiiwasan yan. Talaga magagamit po yan sa eleksyon. Kung ito'y nangyari last year, medyo malabo po yan dahil malayo pa eleksyon. Pero ngayon, papalapit ng eleksyon, given po yan, magagamit.